look, this legislative pathway is absolutely critical to whether or not you're going to be able to achieve what you want to achieve. What is the path from here, and will it happen? Because without the legislation, you can't get your business off the ground. Pardon the pun.
Yeah, well, hey, good morning, Ed. Thanks for having me. Yeah, no, we've had one of the dumbest regulations ever in aviation. In 1973, we put a speed limit in place over land. And what that means is we could fly supersonic from the U.S. to Europe or from U.S. to Asia, but we can't fly supersonic right here in the U.S. And with our test flights in January and February, we proved we can fly supersonic with no audible sonic boom. And I think this is just common sense. If we can fly coast to coast supersonic without any sonic boom that anybody hears in the ground, obviously that should be allowed.
The big political point here for those lawmakers is that your competitors pursuing this field on the technology side are in China, are they not?
Yeah, I think we really are watching a slow motion train crash here. Right now, China is shipping a 737 clone. They're working on a Boeing 787 clone. Boeing has not made an all new airliner in over 20 years now. And China announced earlier this year they've entered the supersonic race. We still have the opportunity to maintain American leadership in aviation, but we've got to get out of our own way. We've got to cut the red tape that's been holding back progress in flight for 52 years.
Blake, this administration, the Trump administration, has been quite engaged in the field of autonomous driving, in eVTOL, for example. Have you spoken with Transport Secretary Duffy or indeed met with the president to discuss America's efforts in supersonic?
The president has a model of the Overture airliner that I think he keeps outside of the Oval Office. We've had great conversations with multiple cabinet members, including Secretary Duffy. It's really hard to find anybody who wants to continue to hold flight back. And now that we've proven that we can have supersonic flights that an audible boom, really, this is something that I think everybody can be behind.
Your technology is in the design of the wings, but mostly in this engine, right? Where are you at in agreements to build the plane, the engine at commercial scale?
You know, the surprising thing about Boomless Cruise is it's actually a software fix. It's not about the wings or the engine exactly. It's actually about how you fly the airplane such that the boom never reaches the ground. And that's a software innovation that's actually pretty easy to deploy. And as we speak today, you know, we've proven we can build a supersonic jet with the XB-1. We're building the first full-scale Symphony engine. That's the first independently developed supersonic jet engine. It's going to be running on a test stand around the end of the year. And we're looking forward to start building the first airliner on our factory in North Carolina next year.
What I recognize in some analogous fields like eVTOL, for example, is a pivot or shift away from consumer passenger model to looking at defense applications. Is that in Boom Supersonic's future, Blake?
Well, the factory that we're building, all the infrastructure we're building, you know, if worse came to worse in wartime, we could pivot from building civil products to building defense products. I think that's an important sort of rebirth in the defense industrial base. However, the most important thing, you know, I think we could do for the U.S. government is provide faster transportation for the most important people. We'd love to replace the rusty old 757s and 747s that carry around our VIPs today with airplanes that could help them arrive in half the time.
I never flew on Concorde. You know, I kind of have this peripheral knowledge of it from when I was a kid. But I think about what XB-1 did in January, right? And that you reached Mach 1.122 at 35,000 feet. How are you going to sort of self-assess your next milestones? What are the next milestones?
Yeah, well, it's a matter of scaling up. XB-1 was the first airliner that was actually built out of proven airliner technology that scales up to build a supersonic airliner. And so we're just scaling up. So next milestone is a full-scale engine around the end of this year. Next milestone after that is construction of the first full-scale airliner. That's next year. We want to roll it out in 27, fly it in 28, conduct extensive testing, and be ready for passengers by the end of 29.
Blake, before we let you go, how capital intensive is this for you? And what are your capital requirements in terms of raising new funds?
Building airplanes is certainly capital intensive, but what we've found is a small focused team enabled with great people, AI design tools can do this about 10 times more efficiently than the big guys can. XB1 was designed, built, and flown by a team of about just 50 people with about a tenth of the capital ever used before to create a supersonic aircraft. So, you know, we will continue to need capital, but it's a shockingly small amount compared to right. what you would see at a Boeing or Airbus.